Last video, we discussed the classification of embedded system, processor in an embedded system, types and the selection of processor. In this video, we will discuss the components of embedded system hardware, various structure units in embedded processor, and features in advanced architecture. This slide shows the main components of embedded system. The first component, hardware similar to a computer. The second component, main application software. And third one is a real-time operating system that is called RTOS. The next slide shows components of an embedded system hardware. Okay, the first one, power source. Second one, clock oscillator, circuit and clocking units. Third one, reset, circuit, power up, reset and watchdog timer. Fourth one, processor. Fifth one, memory. Sixth one, input and output devices. Then seventh one, timer and counter circuit. Then serial communication port, parallel communication port. Last one is interrupt controller. Let's see one by one. The first one, power supply or power source. The power supply source or a charge pump is essential in every system. Second one, clock oscillator circuit and clocking units. For processing units, a highly stable oscillator is required and the processor clock out signal provides the clocks for synchronizing all system units with the processor. Then the third circuit, that is a reset circuit, power up reset and watchdog timer reset. When your program executes, the program counter increments or changes. An important circuit that associates a system is its reset circuit that can change the program counter to a power up default value. A program that is reset and runs on a power up can be one of the following. That means a system program that executes from the beginning, a system boot up program, and a system initialization program. Then the watchdog timer reset is a required feature in control application. Then fourth one, input devices, output devices with input output ports and IO interface circuits. So that means a system connect to the external physical devices and systems through parallel or serial I/O ports. Demultiplexer and multiplexer are used to communication purpose of signals from multiple channel through a common path. A system often networks to the other devices and system through an I/O bus. For example, I2C, CAN, C-A-N, CAN network, USB, ISA, EISA and PCI bus. Then next one, processor, that is microprocessor. So CPU is a unit that centrally fetches and processes a set of general purpose instructions. The CPU instruction set includes instruction for data transfer operation, ALU operation, stack operation, IO operation, and program control, sequencing, and supervising operations. So the general purpose instruction set is always specific to specific CPU unit. Any CPU must possess the following basic functional units. The first functional unit is a control unit that fetches and controls the sequential processing of a given command or instruction or communicates with the rest of the system. Then second point is an ALU that undertakes the arithmetic and logical operations on bytes or words. It may be capable of processing 8-bit, 16-bit, 32-bit or 64-bit words at an instant. A microprocessor is used as a general purpose processor when large embedded software has to be located in the external memory chips. Suppose microcontroller means microcontroller act as processor unit, or controller unit means microcontroller is an integrated chip that has the processor, memory and several other hardware units. A few of the latest microcontroller also have dual core and high computational and superscalar processing capabilities. Okay, so important microcontroller chip for embedded system are 8051 microcontroller, then 68HC11XX or HC12XX, HC16, then PIC16F84 or PIC16676 or F876 or PIC18 microcontroller, then enhancement of a ARM processor, that is ARM processor 9-7 from ARM processor, then Intel processor, Philips, Samsung and ST microelectronics. These are the examples of microcontroller. The microcontroller is used in a small or part of the embedded software, has to be located in the internal memory, and when an on-chip functional units recommend interrupt handler, porch, then timers, ADC, then pulse width modulator and CAN controller are required. Okay, then next one, single purpose processor, that is SPP. So SPP used in embedded system include, that is coprocessor, graphics processor, then pixel coprocessor, then encryption engine, then decryption engine, then a discrete cosine transformation, then inverse transformation processor, then protocol stack processor, network processor, accelerator, coder and decoder, then JPEG codec, MPEG codec, controller. So single purpose processor are used for a specific application or computation, or as a controllers for peripherals, direct access and buses. Okay, then the next one is a memory unit. So actually various forms of system memory available, that is a internal RAM at a microcontroller, then RAM at a system on chip or external RAM, then internal cache at a microprocessor, then external RAM chip, then flash memory or EEPROM, external and internal, then ROM or PROM, external and internal, then memory addresses at the system port. Okay, so these are the various forms of system memory. Actually, a system locates the following either in the internal flash or ROM, PROM, or in an external flash or ROM, PROM of the microcontroller. Okay, then boot up program, initialization data, then strings or pictogram for screen display or initial state of the system, then programs for various tasks, ISR, in service register, then operating system kernel. Okay, then the system has a RAM for saving temporary data, stack and buffer that are needed during a program run. Then system uses a flash memory for storing non-volatile results. So this is about a memory, okay, program memory and data memory. Okay, then next block is system timers and real-time clock. Actually, to schedule the various tasks and for real-time programming, the RTC or system clock is needed. So clock also drives the timers for various timing and counting needs in a system. Okay, then the next block, that is a DAC using pulse width modulator and an ADC. For automatic control and a signal processing application, a system provides necessary interfacing circuits and software for digital to analog conversion unit and analog to digital conversion unit. DAC operation is done with the help of a combination of a pulse width modulator unit in the microcontroller and an external integrator chip. Then ADC operation are required for data acquisition, image processing, voice processing, video processing, instrumentation and automatic control system. The next block is LCD, LED and touchscreen display. So these are all output devices. Okay, so the system may need the necessary interfacing circuit and software for the output to the LCD display controller and LED interfacing port or for the I/O with the touchscreen. Then next one, keypad or keyboard. So this is input devices. So for input, keypad or keyboard may interface to a system. The system provides a necessary interfacing circuit and software to receive input directly from the keys through a controller. Okay. Then the last one, that is a pulse dialer, modem and transceiver. In communication system, pulse dialer, modem and transceiver is used. A system provides the necessary interfacing circuit and a software for dialing and for the modem and transceiver directly or through a controller. Then interrupt handler. So interrupt handler means a system provides an interrupt handling mechanism for executing for ISR, that is a in service request register, in case of a interrupt from physical devices or systems or software instructions and software exceptions. So this is about a component of an embedded system hardware. So the next slide shows the various structural units in an embedded processor. See the ALU and FLPU. Okay, ALU already you know, arithmetic logic unit. FLPU means floating point unit. Okay, ALU, FLPU, so arithmetic and logical operation unit and a floating point operational unit. So floating point operational unit associates FLP register set for operation. Then catchers. So catchers means instruction, data, branch target catchers and associated for prefetching the instruction or data and next branch target instructions respectively. Then AOU. AOU means atomic operation unit. That means an instruction is broken into number of processor. Instruction called atomic operation. AOU finishes the AOs before an interrupt of an processor occurs. See the next slide. So this is the expansion of each unit. So that is a MAR, memory address register. So this unit or this register hold the address of the byte or words to be fetched from external memory. Then processor issues the address of the instruction or data to MAR before it initiate a fetch cycle. So that is the function of a MAR. The next one, MDR. MDR means a memory data register. The function of a MDR is it holds a byte or word fetched from R2 an external memory or IO address. So that is the function of MDR. Then third one, system bus. So already you know system bus contains an internal bus, address bus and a data bus. Internal bus that is initially connect all the structural units inside the processor. Its width can be 8 bit or 64, 8 bit to 64, that is 8 bit, 16 bit, 32 bit, 48 or 64 bits. Then address bus, an external bus that carries the address from MAR to memory as well as IO device and other units of the system. So it is a unidirectional bus. Then third one, data bus. External bus that carries during a read or a write operation the bytes for instruction or data from R to an address. The address is determined by MAR. Okay, then next unit is BIU, bus interface unit. This unit interfaces between processor and processor internal unit and external bus. So that is the function of BIU. Next one is IR, instruction register. It sequentially takes instruction codes to execute a unit of processor. That is the function of IR. Then ID means instruction decoder. It decodes the instruction received at the IR and passes it to processor controller unit. So this is the function of instruction decoder. Then CU means a control unit. So control unit controls all bus activities and unit function needed for processing. Then ARS. ARS means application register set. So here four functions. The first function is a set of a chip register used during processing of instruction of an application program. Otherwise a register window is used. Otherwise a subsystem of a register with each subset storing static variables of a software routine, or a register file associated to a unit such as a ALU. So these are the functions of ARS. Then ALU. So ALU means arithmetic logic unit. So a unit to execute arithmetic and logical instructions to the current instruction present at instruction register. That is the function of ALU. Then PC means a program counter. Program counter generates an instruction cycle by sending the address defined by it to memory through MAR. Then it auto increments as the instruction are fetched regularly and sequentially. It is called an instruction pointer in 8086 processor. Okay, then next one, stack pointer. So stack pointer means a pointer for an address which correspond to a stack top in memory. Okay, that is called stack pointer. Then in future, these points will be considered while selecting a processor. See, in the first one, fixed instruction cycle type, time taken to execute a simple instruction. Then 32-bit internal bus width to the use of availability of arithmetic operation on 32-bit operand in a single cycle. Then program counter bits and reset value. Then stack pointer bits width and its initial reset value. So these points are considered while selecting a processor. Okay. Then this slide shows advanced architecture features. That is, a processor has instruction, a branch target and data cache, then memory management unit, then floating point processing unit, then system register set, then floating point register set, then prefetch control unit, instruction level parallelism unit, that is a multi-stage pipeline architecture or multi-line superscalar processing architecture. Okay, so this consists of RISC architecture. Then execute most instruction on a single clock cycle, execution per second. Then using multiple register set or register windows or files. Then greatly reducing ALU dependency on the external access for data due to the reduced number of addressing modes provided for ALU instruction. Then it includes the instruction pipelining units. So these are the features in advanced architecture.